was reading this book here about Skälby during the Iron Age. This Skälby existed from here to here in the timeline. Founding of Rome, Parthenon was built, Gauls take Rome, Alexander the Great existed, Hannibal, Julius Caesar, and so on. Pompeii started to make weapons and tools from bronze, but they were not very durable. But it was good climate. Then came the Iron Age. They started to make weapons and tools from iron. They were more durable and they started to mass produce weapons and tools. But the climate was worse. It was colder. It was more damp. People started to move around. So there was more conflicts. And that's why they built all these forts during the Iron Age to defend themselves. So while I was reading this book, there was actually northern lights outside. My son came down and said, but then they imagined, okay, the house must have looked like this. And they found bones from these animals, cows and pigs, horses and so on. And Lake Mälaren was just around the corner. And they found bones from two types of fish, bass, it's abborre, and one more type of fish, it's called gädda. So it might have looked like this. Imagine life in the village, Skälby village, and they had fences around the farmland so the animals wouldn't get into the farmland, but the animals were able to move freely outside the farmland. And here's an Iron Age house, as they imagined it. So something like this is probably what it looked like in Skälby during the Iron Age. So tomorrow I'll go outside to another fort, so if I would turn into a bird, like they say in Northern mythology, in Bird's Haven or Bird's Harbor or Bird's Shape, Fågelhamn in Swedish. I could fly about 4 kilometers to the northwest and I'd find another Iron Age fort. So let's see what that looks like. Now I'm at northern part of Skälby, out biking, in early morning. Sun is just risen. And here is the beginning of a hiking trail that goes all through Västmanland. Most people go up to the north, follow some hiking trail and walk for days. But it's easy to just start at home. And there's a sign, I don't know if you can see it, it's at Brunsleden. And the trail starts right here into the woods and goes all through Västmanland. And then after about 1 kilometer it joins up with this biking road again. Now I'm biking over this road, E18, while Bruksleden goes under this road. Just a little bit to the west over there. And a few hundred meters straight up here, Bruksleden joins up with this bicycle road again. Now I got the Ekstrand Shopping Center to my right, to the east of me, and here straight in front of me. Here you can actually see Bruksleden, I think, down here beside the bike road. And it's a little bit icy right now. And here it should join up with the bicycle road, yeah, just here, this Bruksleden. And here it goes over there at the trees at the 90 degrees turn. Bruksleden continues into the woods. There's a 90 degrees turn. There's Citygross at the Ekstrand Shopping Center. And right here is the wooden sign, it says Bruksleden, and over there is an information sign. Let's go look at it. So up here, power lines, and on the normal map the power lines are probably not marked, but if you have this Naturkartan, which is the map from Lantmäteriet, then you see power lines, you see height marks, everything. So there's some information about Bruksleden. It is divided into 27 stages, and stage number 4 starts over here. I believe it goes, should go right here. Go past this field and then take a right. And this hiking trail, yeah, it actually goes here. Now I'm at the hiking trail. So So I'm gonna park my car over here, it's small gravel road. Bruksled. So according to map, this naturkartan should only need to follow this trail to get up on Skansberget, the hill fort. So it said in the book that I read, the one about Skälby, that these hill forts, people might not have lived in the actual hill forts, but lived below in those Iron Age houses and growing crops and stuff like that. And then when enemies came close, they could have fled up to the hill fort to defend themselves because of bad weather, climate change. So during the migration period, and they had advanced weapons, then there was some fighting, or at least that's the theory, what the archaeologists think. The wall goes from over there, here, up there. This would have been a pretty good place to defend. There's remains of a wall. People lifted these stones up here. So there's that might have been the outer wall, and then here's an inner wall, so I had double walls, maybe. Yeah, that's much more left of the wall here than at the Berghagen Hill Fort. So there are 49 of these hill forts in Västmanland only. And in all over Sweden, there's more than 1,000 of these hill forts. And there's one that has been reconstructed, and it is on the island Öland. And Ö means island in Swedish. So Öland, translated to English, becomes island land. Let's see if I can go up the wall here. Yeah, without destroying it. With my non-negligible weight. Yeah, I guess the camping site should be here somewhere. Yeah, over there. Pretty cool wall here. If enemies came down from this direction, they would have had some difficulties attacking the residents up here. So if you're walking the hiking trail, you can stop here and eat some food, and then you can continue walking towards Vargberget. These orange markings are here and there along the trail. So I guess if you just follow those, you won't get lost. There's stairs with some super slippery ice, and then steep stairs. Perfect. Back home, and I'm back in with this book. So I think this would conclude our little Iron Age adventure. So here is what it might have looked like: farmers farming the land, had oxes plowing. This would have been of wood. Maybe this was of iron, more durable than wood. So, I don't know what this is in English, maybe plow. Here are some more tools that would have been available during the Iron Age, some kind of, yeah, whatever that's called in English. This is maybe a scythe, and this is a shorter What's its name? Miraculix in Asterix used to cut herbs to make the miracle potion. And here are pictures of actual findings in Skälby. So here's part of the sky and here's part of this Miraculix Asterix tool.